Hello children, we are doing chapter number 5 of your physics books, class 8, and the name of the chapter is Upthrust in Fluids, Archimedes' Principle and Flotation. The objectives of the chapter are, in this chapter we will be doing definition of upthrust, its properties, reason for upthrust, buoyancy, conditions for a body to float or sink in a liquid, Archimedes' principle and its proof, density, relative density and its measurement, flotation and principle of flotation, relation between volume of submerged body and density of the fluid, applications of principle of flotation. Our topic of the day is upthrust is equal to weight of displaced liquid, mathematical proof, factors affecting upthrust and effect of upthrust. These topics are given on page number 105 and 106 of your books. Objectives of the topic. In this topic, we will prove that upthrust exerted by a liquid on a body submerged in it is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced by the body. We will also discuss the factors affecting upthrust and effect of upthrust on weight of the body. So, let us start with our today's topic, that is, upthrust is equal to weight of displaced liquid, mathematical proof. Before starting this topic, we need to understand its diagram. So, let us discuss the diagram first. In this diagram, we have a body PQRS completely submerged in a liquid. PQ is the upper surface of the body, which is at depth H1 from the free surface of the liquid. RS is the lower surface of the cylindrical body, which is at depth H2 from the free surface of the liquid. P1 is the pressure exerted by the liquid of depth H1 on the upper surface of the body. P2 is the pressure exerted by the liquid on the lower surface of the body, RS, due to depth H2. F1 is the downward force exerted due to liquid which is above the surface PQ of the body, and F2 is the upthrust, the upward force exerted on the body. The area of cross section of the body is A. Let us start with the derivation. At depth H1, pressure on the upper surface PQ, P1 is equal to H1 rho G. We all know, my dear children, that the formula for pressure at a depth is P is equal to H rho G, where H is depth of the body, rho is density of the liquid, and G is acceleration due to gravity. So, according to this formula, we got P1 is equal to H1 rho into G. So, the force F1, force is equal to pressure into area, we all know. So, here is our F2. F2 is equal to H2 rho G into A. Now, my dear children, in this diagram, we know that H2 is greater than H1. So, pressure 2 is greater than pressure 1. So, F2, the force F2, upthrust is greater than F1. As H2 is greater than H1, P2 will be greater than P1. So, F2 is greater than F1. So, as we know, F1 is acting vertically downward. F2 is acting vertically upward. They both will try to balance each other. As F2 is a little more than F1, there will be a net force acting on the body which will be in upward direction, and this force is known as upthrust acting on the body by the liquid. Here it is. The net resultant upward thrust or buoyant force on the body FB is equal to F2 minus F1. F2, as we all know, is H2 rho GA minus F1 is H1 rho GA. We will take A common here. A will be common, rho is common and G is common. So we'll be left with FB is equal to A, H2 minus H1 inside the bracket, rho into G. As we all know, area into height is volume. So A, H2 minus H1 is equal to volume of the body submerged in the liquid. So FB will be volume into rho into G. So here we have up thrust is equal to V rho G. Now V rho G. V is volume of solid immersed, rho is density of the liquid, and G is acceleration due to gravity. Since a solid when immersed in liquid displaces the liquid equal to the volume of its submerged part, therefore the volume of solid immersed will be equal to volume of liquid displaced. So here at this place, volume of solid immersed, we can write volume of liquid displaced. So V rho G can be written as volume of liquid displaced into density of liquid into acceleration due to gravity. Now volume into density is mass of the liquid displaced. So it will be mass of the liquid displaced into acceleration due to gravity. Mass into acceleration is weight. Mass of the liquid displaced into acceleration due to gravity will be weight of the liquid displaced by the submerged part of the body. So ultimately we got up thrust, which is equal to V rho G, is equal to weight of the liquid displaced by the submerged part of the body, which was our derivation. So we got up thrust is equal to weight of the liquid displaced by the submerged part of the body. Now there are some important points to be discussed.
Note number one, if the body is completely immersed in a liquid, the volume of liquid displaced will be equal to its own volume, and up thrust then will be maximum. Second, although the above result is derived for a cylindrical body, but it is equally true for a body of any shape and size.
Now, our next topic is factors affecting the up thrust. The formula for up thrust is up thrust is equal to V rho G, where V is volume of the body submerged in the liquid, rho is density of the liquid, and G is acceleration due to gravity. At a particular place, G acts as a constant. Its value is 9.8 meter per second square on the surface of Earth. So, as G is acting as a constant, we'll be left with two factors. So, the factors affecting up thrust are, first is volume of the body submerged in the liquid or fluid, and the second is density of the liquid in which the body is submerged.
Next is effect of up thrust. The effect of up thrust is that the weight of body immersed in a liquid appears to be less than its actual weight. This can be explained with the help of this diagram. This diagram shows a spring balance measuring a same body in air and in water, measuring the weight of a same body in air and then in water. When this spring balance measures the weight of the body in air, its reading came out to be nearly 15. Now, when the same spring balance is used to measure the weight of the same body which is immersed in water, the reading came out to be nearly 8.5. This happened because when body is immersed in water, there will be some up thrust exerted by the water on the body. Now, weight of the body acts vertically downward. Up thrust acts vertically upward. Both will try to balance each other. As we have discussed already, F2 is greater than F1. in this derivation which we have just now discussed. So there will be net force acting on the body in upward direction, which is known as up thrust. So this is the effect of up thrust. The effect of up thrust is that the weight of body immersed in a liquid appears to be less than its original weight. Let us discuss an experiment related to this. Experiment: lifting of a bucket full of water from a well. Take an empty bucket and tie a long rope to it. If the bucket is immersed in water of a well, keeping one end of rope in hand, and the bucket is pulled when it is deep inside water, we notice that it is easy to pull the bucket as long as it is inside the water, but as soon it starts coming out of water surface, it appears to become heavy and now more force is needed to lift it. The reason you people know, my dear children, when it is inside the water, there will be some up thrust exerted by the water on it, which will decrease its weight to a little extent. This experiment shows that the bucket of water appears lighter when it is immersed in water than its actual weight. That means than its weight in air. Similarly, pushing a fish out of water, it appears lighter inside water as compared to when it is out of water. Similarly, a body weighed by a sensitive spring balance will weigh slightly less in air than in vacuum due to up thrust of air on the body. So this was our today's topic. Please practice the derivation discussed today and mark the back exercise question answers, question 15 till 19, which is given on page number 110 of your books. We will continue with our next topic in our next video. Thank you so much.